This video is brought to you by Brilliant. The most priceless thing that we all run out of on this planet is time. We're often too busy to realize that we can salt away this inestimable non-spatial continuum by spending a pinch of it on optimizing and organizing our routines with the help of the devices that waste most of it, our phones. Today, I will show you how to save at least an hour a day by providing you with perhaps the most essential 10 iPhone tips. Now, I assume you wouldn't mind saving 15 days out of a year, right? Before we get to the nitty-gritty facepalm tips, let's start with the most apparent first tip. Learn your iPhone. Too many people are using their iPhones the way the device was introduced in 2007. Endless amount of app icons spread in excess amount of home screens, where the intimidation factor keeps many locked into pointless swiping and fruitless searching for something. In front of me, I have examples that belongs to friends of mine to illustrate this fact. No offense to any of them, I love you all. The latest iPhone operating system versions offer app recommendations, folders, automation, and widgets that can significantly reduce the time you spend locating or executing something. An example I can give you is my current home screen. Now, I won't get into many details on how I have it set up since I'll be releasing a separate video on the topic of the most optimal iPhone setup, yet I want to point out that everything I require and use can be contained in just a single home screen. The point of this tip is to reduce the time spent on chronic interactions. Tip number two is to get to know Siri. As a friend of mine pointed out for this tip, a good relationship is built on trust. Although Siri has matured to offer a lot, learn the basics. Instead of opening Google Translate to search for a word in a foreign language, ask Siri to translate it for you. Googling conversions is a thing of the past since you can ask Siri to tell you how tall are you in centimeters or how many stones you weigh. Weather is something that I ask for every day, so is setting up a countdown timer or an alarm. Reminders are priceless when driving the car with CarPlay. Grabbing a to-do on time via Siri could save you a lot more than just a few minutes writing the task down. If you quarrel with someone, save a few minutes searching for the fact in question and just ask for it. If you need to leave it to chance, stop hunting for a coin or simply roll a dice. Best of all these interactions can be done without even touching the phone. We're not only talking about saving time here, but also reducing friction. Some of you might be laughing at me, but the most recent realization and one of my current biggest time savers is using the nav and specifically Waze. Despite knowing every pothole in any of the possible routes I can take on my daily commute, Waze can save me 10 minutes to half an hour daily. Based on the live traffic information, I'm told the fastest route with the least amount of traffic alongside a police report. Last time I had a chance to conduct a quick experiment and witnessed how an incident was reported on Waze within the first 2 minutes of its occurrence. The app is community-based where everyone participates and it's a lot of fun too since you can customize how it looks and interacts with you. Google Maps is also great for many of the same reasons as mentioned earlier, although you'll get to appreciate your fellow driver's input on Waze. The next tip is all about capturing commitments. Here's what I mean. Ideas, thoughts, and realizations often occur at the least expected times. Coming up with a solution to a problem or a choice to a dilemma can be invaluable, yet capturing them on time has proven to be the biggest obstacle. The answer to those aha moments has to be as frictionless as possible, and the app that I use for those moments is called Just Press Record. It's a very simple yet powerful app that allows me to record whatever comes to my mind. I've set up a widget on my phone, but I often use the Apple Watch to just press and record. What's great is that I can transcode the voice memos into text that I can later on use as the foundation for whatever I had in mind. I wish I had a CarPlay support. Nevertheless, I created a Siri shortcut to where I'd say record, and it will immediately start recording a voice memo. While on the topic of capturing commitments, the next tip I have is all about task lists. Note that I'm not referring to just tasks, but actual lists that are used regularly. Any task app can serve the purpose. In my case, I choose to use Things in combination with Notes and Notion. Things is my daily chores tool where, aside from the usual today and upcoming tasks, I have created lists for packing, tech and gear, what to buy, groceries, home and garden, and more. Let me give you an example. I've been meaning to purchase a battery-powered garden sprayer for the longest of time. Yet every time I go to a home improvement store for something else, I forget about the garden's prayer. Nothing urgent here, yet something that I've been postponing for probably 2 years, the result of which has been manual, time-consuming spraying in anger of my forgetfulness. Such lists don't hold daily tasks, but rather things that we realize we need to do at any given time, things that we can refer to when necessary. Quick access is tip number 6 here. Think of it this way. If you were to go somewhere, would you pick the longest route? If we talk about going to work, for example, would you keep on picking the longest route every day? Of course not. Yet way too many people choose to overclick their ways to get to a folder, note, or document or something else daily. Why not create quick access shortcuts to whatever you're most often using? As we've discussed in the past minimal max setup video, which I'll link at the end of this one, creating shortcuts saves us a ton of time and keeps us sane. If I happen to access a folder more than 3 times daily, I immediately push it to my favorite section on the Files app. Since I always create tasks, I've created a Things widget on the homepage of my phone with a tap away access to a new task. No need to open the app first, go to Today section and pressing on the plus button. This methodology should be the cornerstone of everyone who cares about productivity improvement. If you search, go or click on something often, create quick access to it. To take a breath for a moment, let's immediately shave off at least 15 minutes a day by turning off all social media notifications. You probably know this, but all social media platforms want you to return to them as often as possible. Notifications are like having a candy that drops in front of your face all the time. As much as you want to resist the sugar, everyone eventually caves. When you turn off all social media notifications, you'll become an intentional user. You become the boss and not the other way around. To prove my point, try turning off all social media notifications just for a day and compare the screen time results on your smartphone afterwards. You probably noted that saving an hour a day is a little over 15 days a year. That's 4% of your annual time that you could spend on something worthwhile. Part of my time saving, I invest in improving my problem-solving skills. For example, I'm currently taking Brilliant's course on everyday math. As I mentioned, changing the perspective, take a look at this figure. At a glance, it might not be apparent if there's more of one color than the other, unless, similar to our annual time-saving dissection, we divide the entire shape into some smaller squares to reveal the answer that the totals of yellow and white areas must be equal, changing perspectives to get a better understanding. To change your own perspective and invest some of your saved time, check out Brilliant, since it is an amazing tool for learning STEM interactively. It is the best way to learn at your own pace wherever you are, even on the go. To get started for free, visit brilliant.org/thisise or click on the link in the description, and the first 200 of you will get 20% off Brilliant's annual premium subscription. Next up is replying to people. If you get an email with a question or a debacle, instead of resorting to the usual detailed step-by-step instruction writing spree, use the screen recording functionality on the iPhone to explain everything. When you long press on the screen recording feature of the iPhone, a microphone icon appears, and this is pretty much all you need. Instead of writing 10-minute long emails, do a quick 2-minute free speech explanation, which I'm sure will be more beneficial to the other party as well, because let's be honest, no one likes reading long emails. Also, your thumbs will thank you. Instead of screen recording, feel free to use a voice memo too. When we talk about messages, long replies can also be avoided by recording your message as a voice iMessage, which the recipient can choose to save later. To prove my point, here's how long it takes to write a paragraph on the iPhone compared to just sending a voice note. I'm trying to up my returning viewers, as only 17% of you manage to find me again and again. If you end up enjoying this video and you want to find out what's next on the channel, subscribe and click on the bell icon, because why not? Next up, payments. Take advantage of the Apple Wallet app and insert your most used cards. Even the slightest time-saving habit of using the phone instead of taking out your wallet and trying to pull out the correct card will be worth it. If you wear an Apple Watch, things get even better in the time-saving department, since you can just flex for a second on the terminal and move on with your life. Keeping your cards in the Apple Wallet will save you even more time when making online payments, since Apple Pay is worldwide and you won't have to enter credit card information manually. Give me a moment for this next tip.
Instead of reading everything, use the built-in speak feature of the iPhone. If you have a long email or an article that you'd like to catch up with, select the text and press the speak feature. The phone will read you everything you need to know while you wash the dishes. Turn your daily routines into an audiobook.
If you enjoyed this video, check out this playlist. And if you got this far, subscribe. And until next time, it's been an absolute pleasure. This is E, over and out.